Hi everyone. Today we are going to see the scope of psychology, and it is very important topic in the psychology. So before going to the scope of psychology, we will just see the meaning and the nature of psychology. So welcome to the meaning of psychology. The term psychology, it is derived from two Greek words, that is the psyche and logos. The meaning of psyche, it is nothing but the soul, and the logos, that refers to the study of. So the meaning of psychology then comes to the study of soul. But later what happens, so many psychologists, they have come and the development of psychology has been improved. Then they have found out that the term soul, it is an inadequate one and vaguely it is using. Then what happened, William James, he had given the term mind instead of soul, and the term has been replaced into the mind. And then it came, the psychology, the word, it came like the study of mind. And if you move to the definition says that the psychology, it is a study of mind and cognitive processes. And some other definition, it says that psychology is the study of behavior and cognitive process. Then came the question, what's mind and behavior? The mind is nothing but it is an imaginary concept. And it says that, some of them says that the mind, it is the functions of brain. And what's cognitive process? Cognitive process are nothing but it is a different functions of brain, like attention, perception, emotion, learning, memory, forgetting, etc. And what is behavior? Behavior is nothing but it, these are the various activities we do. That means it comes over facial expression and the observable activity of an individual. It is termed as a behavior. So that comes the meaning and definition of psychology. Then we'll see regarding the nature of psychology. So how the psychology will be. Psychology, when come to the nature, we can say that psychology is a universal one. Universal is nothing but it is applied to every individual. And that means that different age groups, starting from infant, toddler, and preschool, school age, until old age, all the age group, they are having different types of psychological development. That's why it is saying universal, as well as the psychology is applied in all the countries or worldwide. It may be in India, or it may be in Western country, or it may be in the Gulf countries. Wherever you go, the psychology is applicable. That's why we can say that the psychology is a universal one. Then we can say that the psychology is a scientific one. Why we are saying psychology is a scientific one? Because we are using different scientific methods in psychology, as well as the result of psychology, various principles or various theories can be verified at any time and in different areas. Then it is a valid, the result will be reliable and it is valid one. And the next one, the psychology is an art too. Then come to the next one, the scope of psychology. The scope of psychology means the, what are the different areas it can be used. And here in the scope of psychology, we'll discuss under the branches of psychology. Welcome to the branches of psychology. The psychology is having mainly two different branches. One is a pure branch and another is a applied branch. So first we'll see regarding the pure branches of psychology. So welcome to the pure branches. The first one is a general psychology. So what do you mean by the general psychology? The general psychology is nothing but here the basic fundamental principle and the theories of psychology will be applied in relation to the human behavior. That means in the general psychology, mainly we'll be discussing regarding the attention of an individual, how we perceive, then the learning process, then the emotional process of motivation. All these things we'll study in the general psychology. Come to the next one, that is the developmental psychology. So what is the developmental psychology? So all the human beings, they'll be going through the different stages. Maybe like if it starts from the intrauterine period. That means when the baby is in mother's uterus, there itself the growth and development will be starting from the intrauterine period. Then it moves to the infancy period, then toddler, preschool, school age, adult, and it comes to the old age period. So all the individuals are going through these different stages. Their growth and development will be discussed in this particular branch of psychology. So come to the next one, it is the physiological psychology. So what is the physiological psychology? So it comes to physiology behind the psychology. That means it comes to various processes, the functioning of brain, functioning of central nervous system, and various functions of hormones, that is the endocrine system, behind the human behavior. So come to the next branch, it is nothing but the social psychology. So, in the social psychology, we'll discuss regarding the human beings relationship, means interrelationship between the human being. That means the human beings are the social animal. So, here the social interaction, social groups, all these things we'll study in the social psychology. Come to the next one, it is the parapsychology. So, what is the parapsychology? In the parapsychology, we'll be mainly discussing regarding the paranormal activities, that is related to the extrasensory perception, or it may be related to the sixth sense, telepathy, psychokinesis, etc. We'll study in the parapsychology. So come to the another branch, that is the applied psychology. So what is the applied psychology? Applied psychology is nothing but the principles or the theories of psychology will be applying into the different field. So come to the first one. The first and important thing is nothing but the educational psychology. So everyone knows regarding the educational psychology very well. It is nothing but the principles of or the theories of psychology will apply in the educational field, especially the theories of learning we are applying in the educational field. So here it is related to the various teaching learning process, how to improve the teaching learning process, or how to identify various learning disorders, everything which comes under the educational psychology. So come to the another important branch of psychology, that is the clinical psychology. In the clinical psychology, it is nothing but the relationship between the psychology and various abnormal behavior. That means the various mental disorder, how we can identify, or what are the various psychological treatment we can use. The psychological treatment may be like psychotherapy, behavior therapy, cognitive behavior therapy, psychoanalytical therapy, all these things will be used in this particular field. Come to the next one, the industrial psychology. So industrial psychology, it is nothing but the psychology of people in the working environment or in the working setup. So here the interaction between the workers, that may be the subordinate or the higher people, or it may be with the employees or with the management, everything we'll be discussing or we'll be studying in the industrial psychology. So come to the next branch of applied psychology, it is nothing but the military psychology. So while coming to the military psychology, so we'll be discussing the psychology of soldiers. So during, suppose if there is a war, so how to improve the character, or how to maintain the moral of the soldiers, or while during the recruitment process we are using various psychological assessment to recruit the soldiers, all these things which comes under the military psychology. So come to the next branch, it is the legal psychology. So the legal psychology, it is nothing but the relationship of psychology between the psychology and with the crime. That means we'll see the psychology of criminal people, or psychology of witness, or what's the motive behind the crime, all these things which comes under the legal psychology. So nowadays we can see that there are legal criminal psychologists are there. They'll be helping the police department to find out different type of crime, everything. So these are the different branches of psychology. So hope everyone understood regarding this particular branches. There are two branches, that is the pure psychology and there is an applied psychology. Thank you.